Hello everyone, I Dr. Anuradha Karmarkar from EISSMS College of Hotel Management and Catering Technology, Pune, welcome you all again to my lecture series, and this time it's going to be on a different topic, greetings, a warm welcome. We are going to talk about greetings across the culture around the world. In hospitality industry, we come across many people, some known and some unknown to us, which makes greeting one of the most fundamental tools, not only to welcome the guest, but also resulting in their satisfaction and to make them feel comfortable and secure at all time. Greeting not only connect two people together, but also helps in bettering the relationship which we are going to have with our guests in the hotel. A warm and sincere greeting can help you go through the guest's most rigid defensive wall without getting a negative response. It helps to initiate a conversation where both the unknown people and we are comfortable talking to each other. And it is the most important tool also to create that very important first impression with the guest. And this first impression is going to take you a long way. With this, we would like to look at different styles of greeting to understand the cultures across different countries and to know people well so that we can greet them in their own style. In hospitality, we witness diversified cultures and we try to inculcate them in our own culture to some extent. Greetings is one of that. So, start with Namaste, which is the greeting style in Nepal and India. And of course, now we can say it's worldwide accepted because of pandemic, because of COVID, and no touch and no contact services. Namaste is the trend which is greeting trend happening worldwide. This is followed for everyone we know for the first time and show respect towards others.
Who are known for following their tradition and culture to the T. Even in today's modern era, people greet each other with a bow in Japan. Depending on the person, their greeting and their social status, the bows differ in angle and duration.
At the same time, duration also will change as per the social status of the person. In Philippines, mano is a word to greet each other. Here, elders are greeted by taking one of their hands gently and pressing it on your forehead. They call it mano, which is hand in Spanish and is used to show respect towards elderly people. What's happening in UAE? Usually, we have seen gentlemen greeting each other by pressing their noses together and called as a nose kiss in UAE and Oman, of course seen amongst men. In countries like Tibet, this is a very, very unique style of greeting. Sticking your tongue out, it can happen at Tibet, and don't be surprised. When you see people doing this, they are actually greeting you by pressing their hands together and sticking their tongue out. Unique, isn't it? In Malaysia, the greeting is warm. Malays usually stretch out their hands and touch the other person's fingertips and then bring their hands to their heart. So it is called as heart-to-heart greeting in Malaysia. In another country as Thailand, which again is a popular tourist destination, you will see each and every citizen, a person, will be bending in front of you, bowing, and have and press their hands in front of you to say why. When being introduced in Thailand and greeting someone, usually men say Sawadee Krap, whereas women says Sawadikar. So these are two different phrases to be used by people in Thailand when they greet each other. And usually the head and the hands are in a prayer fashion seen by all. In America, usual handshake and hello is a greeting term which is universally accepted also whenever we meet for the first time for a formal introduction. A handshake is the most common greeting style in USA. Besides this, if it's an informal greeting, people can hug each other, and that is also considered as social greeting. Handshakes should be firm and accompanied with direct eye contact throughout the greeting, especially in business contexts. In France, bonjour and bonsoir, which is good morning and good evening in French, are the common terminologies used for greeting. A kiss on both cheeks is a very, very familiar way of greeting each other, either formally or informally. It is customary in France to plant a kiss on each cheek when meeting somebody new or familiar as an indication of friendship and affection, as you can witness in this picture. And the same is followed in most of the European countries. Let's go to Africa. Jambo is the key word of greeting each other in Swahili. They shake hands with each other, but the shaking style is little different. They hold the hand and then shake each other's hand. It is important to greet everyone respectfully and immediately upon seeing them. The most common greeting is the handshake, accompanied with eye contact and a smile. Post-handshake, clapping is another culture which is seen in greetings in Zimbabwe. After shaking hands, people clap, and that's another unique style of greeting each other. In Sri Lanka, Ayubovan is a very, very common terminology which is used in Sinhalese language. Whereas in Tamilian, it is called as Vanakkam. So the traditional greeting is often accompanied with these phrases in Sri Lanka, and which means, may you be blessed with a long life. So Ayubovan is another terminology. So students, we have seen different greeting phrases and styles across the world. I have taken only few glimpses of it. There may be different styles still prevailing in other cultures, which may be covered in next slides. But we cannot ignore the traditional welcome. Being a hotelier, how guests can be welcomed. So in Sri Lanka, people are usually welcomed in traditional outfit, as you can see, and a bunch of lilies which can be offered to the guest. Ayubovan is a phrase which can be used. In Russia, offering salt and bread. Slovenia, Romania, Russia, these are the countries who follow this culture of offering bread and salt whenever you meet someone or welcome someone traditionally. In India, ATG, Aarti, Tilak and Garland is the way of welcoming a guest, where kumkum is put on the forehead of the guest and a garland across their neck to welcome them. Either to a hotel or anywhere you visit as a tourist also. In UAE, whenever you welcome someone traditionally, usually their traditional drink and dates, which can be stuffed or otherwise, can be offered to the guests on their arrival to welcome them out of respect. With this, we come to an end of the presentation. So I thank you for patiently attending to this presentation. I hope this created some kind of interest in you and a scope for learning other cultures and greeting styles. For my presentation, I have used several references like wordwidth.wordwidthdj.wordpress.com and www.afar.com. At the same time, Google images are also included in the presentation, and I'm grateful to the references I have collected from. With this, I would like to end the presentation. Students, don't forget to solve the quiz given in the description box of this presentation. So, see you all in the next lecture series. Until then, have a very nice day. Merci, danke, gracias, and a big thank you.